On the basis of one fragment of Bergman's Scenes from a Marriage, the participating young directors all worked one day with the actors of their choice. In this program, we will show two directors who had chosen the same scene, where Johan comes home to tell his wife that he will leave her for another woman. The first director is Leif Magnusson from Sweden.
It's a scene starting in a normalization, a normal relation, in a way, and then it explodes into a kind of chaotic feelings with a lot of aggression, hate, desperation, and also love. And it goes back to a normalization again, but something which now is completely different than it was before. But this is the progress or the idea of the scene.
What do you expect of the actors? What do you expect?
A catastrophe. Yeah.
But I mean, which is the line which you expect of them? How to develop the feelings, how to change it in the middle of the text? You know where is the points?
Yeah, there are several points.
It's so can you tell us the main points or few really important points?
I'm not sure that I understand what it's, because there are changes all the time. It's like a bombardment, you know, different. But the three main things is just that they start like loving couple. Mm-hmm. She is especially, because she's been very pleased because he's have a lover. He's been very kind to her, but he's have a lover. It affects on her. He's doing little things that he haven't been doing for maybe years, like small. Because he's now with another woman, and this also with her. So Marianne, she's kind of happy. And this will make it very cruel. Yeah. And it's a very long fall for her when he says that he met another woman. There's a lot of aggression from both persons. And it's a little scene about one trying to go after the other. Like a little chasing scene, you know, in a way.
Well, you think he can feel the kind of aggression to her? It's aggression to her? It's a general aggression of the life?
No, it's also a very big aggression against
her.
And in the most kind of desperate position Marianne makes, without really knowing it, a complete change, which also is a big surprise for Johan. And that is that she decides to, in a way, acting like if nothing happened.
Like, why do you think he should feel this kind of aggression?
Why he should think? Because he has been through this marriage, as I see it, with a lot of... is it all right if I hear a little music? I think I read a book. You agree on this? And now, this for one time, they are telling the truth here. That's a very important thing. And they never tell the truth. They never tell what they really feel.
There's no reason to be aggressive.
Yeah, for me, I think there's a lot of aggression in this.
Yeah,
absolutely. But one thing I must say, and that is a good remark you make, that I remember this film as two people, very intellectual and very always aware and concerned about everything, talking like, I do this, you do that, yes, but on the other side I do this and you do that, yes, but... And we want to make it more like emotional, more physical. So I don't remember this particular scene at all, but it will be interesting for me to see it after.
Well, say something, goddammit!
I don't know what to
say. I suppose you think it was wrong of me not to tell you before. But I just didn't want to worry you. What's so funny?
I didn't realize. I wasn't suspicious. I didn't notice anything. everything was just as usual. Or better, in fact. I tell you why I find it difficult.
Mm-hmm.
Because I have this laugh, which you've asked.
Yeah, which should be more hysterical.
Okay. Well, maybe I can do it more hysterical, but at the moment I find it very hard to know my inner reason for the laugh. And so the best reason that I've so far come up with is to realize God, when he rang about the convention,
yeah.
I didn't realize.
Yeah.
And so my laugh, I've already
yes,
done it.
Yes.
And so then if I go on and go, I wasn't suspicious, and discover everything,
yeah.
It feels fake to me. Because I've already discovered it. That's
no, no,
what
no.
my laugh
yes,
is.
Yes, but I absolutely agree. But you are thinking of this like thinking high, you know. You're not telling him, listen, I haven't been suspicious. Listen, I haven't been thinking. More like, I understand everything. And I wasn't suspicious. I wasn't, you know, that it's completely for yourself. And then you've been so kind.
Absolutely.
There it wakes up.
Yeah. You have to discover step by step the situation what happened before, you know.
Okay, but you say step by step, and for me the problem is that when I laugh I already think, but I didn't realize.
Exactly.
Okay, so then what is the next step?
The next step is that you remember that all the times, you know, that he didn't call you, that he called you saying that he will be 2 days later, you know?
Yeah,
that he's leaving for the night one time, and he said it was a kind of party and he has to be there.
Yeah.
But you remember that some colleagues of him never said something about the party.
Yes.
This is, you know?
Yes.
But, shall we do it there, or shall we talk more about this later? Because you have problems with connection from the lab to this.
No, that's now solved.
It's now solved?
That's now solved.
Okay, fine.
Yes, but if you're asking for a different kind of laugh from me, then now is a good time to talk with me about it.
Okay, because this laugh, I also wanted to ask you, it's you know, kind of hysteric reaction, like people laughing at a funeral.
Yeah.
And with this, it's of course, effect for the scene, but also to tell a person, all things are like, so she's laughing and then she's almost crying, you know, to see this.
But
the reason for this is
of what she's loving, of whom she's loving. She's loving of herself.
Yeah, but the cue is, I didn't want to worry.
Yeah, this is, of course.
And it's like...
But when she's loving, you know, it's a different. When she's loving of the situation, when she's loving of him, or she's loving of herself. I think she's loving of herself.
I think so.
I'm so stupid. This is the reason to laugh.
But when if you laugh about yourself, it's not kind of hysteric.
Why not?
Maybe, if it's...
Why not?
Okay.
I think especially when you are loving of yourself, that you are so stupid. I think so.
Yeah, we can discuss. It's just not to have
awareness. Or she can pretend that she's loving. This is also possible.
Yeah. That's also.
Yeah, this I see now, that she's pretend that she's loving. Mm-hmm. It's not true.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't love at all. She's pretend to loving. So she's loving outside, but inside she's crying, yeah?
Notice anything. Everything has been just as normal. Better, in fact. You've been so kind. I think that the problem arises when the director and the actors are not really communicating with each other about what's required. This makes the job harder for everybody. And with this little moment, Leif had asked me as an actress to laugh hysterically. He wanted a very extreme emotion. Now this is a difficult thing to do because you have to find psychologically inside you as an actor what causes this laugh to come out. And I had a problem with this because I couldn't relate it to something in my own experience. This was, you know, very much my own problem. But when I asked Leif for help with this, he couldn't give me an answer that really made sense to me. I said, why do I laugh hysterically? And he said, because I want to surprise the audience. And this is not enough for me to work on. So when we came to doing the shoot, I still hadn't solved the problem. I still had a problem. So I just tried as best I could to do what he wanted. And of course, when I see it on the screen, it's not looking real, because it isn't real.
Nie wiem, co możemy z tego, nie wiem, czy możemy z tego wyciągnąć jakiś wniosek
poza tym. What kind of consequences we should take
poza tym wnioskiem, żeby starać się użyć tego sposobu, który dla danego aktora i dla danej sytuacji jest najlepszy.
What works the best for the specific actor in the specific situation?
Ja myślę, że to można by bardzo starannie omówić na przykładzie śmiechu historycznego.
We can very well discuss this at the example of the hysterical laugh of Dulcy.
Bo to jest ten problem.
Because it's exactly this problem.
Ona pokazuje, że się śmieje historycznie.
She shows that she is hysterically laughing.
Ponieważ nie czuje żadnego powodu, żeby się śmiać historycznie.
Because she doesn't feel any need for any historical laugh.
Poza twoją prośbą.
Except for your request.
Wobec tego pokazuje, że się śmieje historycznie.
So she shows that she is hysterically laughing.
I dlatego w tej scenie
and in this particular scene,
natychmiast czujemy, że to jest fałsz.
We feel immediately this is fake.
I tu właśnie ona przechodzi do pokazywania, ponieważ nie znajduje w sobie realnych powodów.
So she by herself comes to the moment that she shows instead of going through it, because she doesn't have the need to.
A ja myślę, że można sobie wyobrazić bardzo dobrze tą samą
Dulcy
w tej samej sytuacji,
in the same situation,
która rzeczywiście będzie się śmiała hysterycznie.
Where she really will laugh hysterically.
Ale wtedy musisz jej powiedzieć,
but then you have to tell her,
co jej się przypomina.
What she is thinking of.
What co jej się po kolei przypomina.
All of a sudden, what one after another her thoughts.
Jak powoli, z uśmiechu,
and then
z niepokoju właściwie
slowly
najpierw,
from being not quiet and disordered maybe.
Przez uśmiech.
She comes to a small smile.
Pewnie ironiczny, gorzki.
Which probably is a little bit bitter and ironically at this particular moment.
Przechodzi do histerycznego śmiechu.
It slowly, gradually transfers into a hysterical
laugh. Ponieważ myśli sobie, Boże, jaka ja byłam głupia.
Because all of a sudden she realizes at this particular moment, my God, how stupid I have been.
I śmieje się histerycznie z siebie samej.
And then she starts to laugh hysterically about herself.
Yes, but what I wanted to discuss is that maybe all of us have experienced an actor really deeply involved in some feelings which are very appropriate and adequate for the scene, and when you watch it maybe you don't get that strong feeling out of it, and there are actors who are maybe having a little coffee and cigarettes and they are not really, they are more like playing, but when you see them afterwards they've done something which make you believe what of course it's a matter of personality and talent and whatever, but
no wiesz, przedyskutować to nie zdążymy. Istnieją oczywiście zasadnicze różnice.
There are of course essential difference between the two. We have no time to discuss this in details. Yes.
Jest, z jednej strony jest Stanisławski
from
i aktor studio, który wynika ze
Stanisławskiego. Which comes forth from this.
To znaczy przeżycie.
That's really going through the emotion.
I z drugiej strony jest coś kompletnie innego, mianowicie Brecht.
And there is this other way, well, let's say Brecht,
który pokazuje,
that's showing the emotions.
Tylko pokazuje emocje. W moim przekonaniu dla kina absolutnie lepsza jest szkoła, która wychodzi ze Stanisławskiego i przechodzi przez aktor studio.
I rather prefer the school which comes from Stanislavski and actor studio, so going through the emotion instead
to znaczy,
of showing.
Krótko mówiąc, być, a nie grać.
So to be instead of to play.
Oh, shall I take my hair clips out? I'll do as you like.
At least I think I will. I know you don't like them. Oh, come on, darling, let's go to bed. You must be awfully tired. And I'm a bit drowsy too, even though I slept before you came. What is it, Johan? You're worried about something? Something happened. What's wrong? Tell me what it is.
I came home to tell you something. Fallen in love. It's quite absurd, and maybe it's all a damn mistake. It probably is a big damn mistake. In fact, she's studying for a degree. She's not much to look at. You probably think she was ugly. I don't know where this will lead to.
Well, say something, goddammit!
I don't know what to say.
I suppose you think I was wrong? Not telling you before? I just didn't want to worry you.
I wasn't suspicious. I didn't notice anything. Everything was just as usual, better in fact.
I just want to be with you. I feel tired and I feel scared. Well, I know just what you're thinking. I have no excuses to offer.
How can you know what I'm thinking?
Let's not talk. I mean, there's nothing sensible to say anyway. I told you the truth, and that's the main thing.
I don't know anything. Let's go to bed. Let's go to bed.
Ja myślę, że to, co się zdarzyło, to się zdarzyło. To, że po prostu
what happened is this, to my opinion.
Chcąc tą scenę skoncentrować,
you wanted to concentrate the scene.
Straciłeś Straciłeś kontekst wydarzeń. Straciłeś kontekst wydarzeń. Straciłeś.
During this you lost the context of the events.
I w związku z tym straciłeś to, co się dzieje pomiędzy nimi.
And so you lost also what was happening really between them.
I rytm sceny.
And the rhythm of the scene.
Zaczął być gwałtowny i już do końca jest gwałtowny.
Started to become brutal and it remained brutal up till the end.
I nie ma ani chwili odpoczynku.
There is not a moment of rest of.
Moment odpoczynku, moment refleksji.
A moment of reflection, of relax.
Nie ma ani chwili tego.
There is not a single moment of this in the whole scene.
Cały czas przyspieszasz.
You are accelerating all the time.
Opuszczasz pewne rzeczy w dialogu, które nie zgadzały się na zdjęciach i słusznie robisz.
You leave some parts of the dialogue. You decided that upon this during shooting and it was a right decision.
Ale jak gdyby nie zastępujesz tego momentem refleksji.
But you did not replace these moments where you skipped lines by a moment of reflection.
Mi się wydaje, że po prostu stało się tak, że to jest taka wersja, krótko mówiąc, za szybka.
It's a too quick version of the scene.
Myślę, że można byłoby przeprowadzić te uczucia.
I think you could direct the feelings you wanted to have.
Gdybyś się troszeczkę bardziej chwilami zatrzymał nad tym,
and
co
shape them if you just would have these moments of. Well, one step on the spot before going on.
Zamiast ciągle przechodzić od ekspresji do ekspresji.
Because you move from one expression to the next expression.
I tej ekspresji jest za dużo.
And this expression is too much.
I to powoduje, że Nelika czuje się jak w domu wariatu.
And that's why someone like Nelika feels like being in the apartment of madman.
Żeby się zatrzymać, przynajmniej trzy razy masz takie miejsca w tej scenie, w której można się zatrzymać.
There are three places which I noted where you could well remain for a while.
To jest kwestia jak czasem paru sekund, naprawdę.
It's a matter of some seconds only.
Jak zresztą wiesz dobrze z doświadczenia, to jest kwestia czasem nawet paru klatek czystki piątki.
And you know it's only frames of 35.
Które zatrzymują scenę, dają możliwość oddechu, dają możliwość widzowi wejścia w tę scenę.
Possibility to breathe in between and to go on.
Zgadzam się całkowicie z Lucy, jeśli chodzi o ten efekt śmiechu histerycznego. To jest niedobry efekt.
Totally with Dulcie with this effect of this hysterical laugh, which is not a good effect.
I my nie rozumiemy, dlaczego ona się śmieje.
We don't understand at all why she smiled.
I wanted to carry it out, but it was impossible.
To jest trudne, to jest trudno wyrzucić to.
It's difficult to skip this.
Ale można to wyrzucić.
But you can.
Drugi moment, który uważam, że trzeba ominąć. I to
koniecznie. And it's a second moment, which you absolutely should skip.
To jest moment, w którym Dulcie podchodzi do planu średniego.
When Dulcie comes to the medium plan.
I przeżywa to, co usłyszała przed chwilką.
And where she has this, what she was just talking about.
To jest moment, w którym ona stoi.
There's moments where she stands there.
Próbuje, chce zapłakać, opanowuje się, odwraca się i wraca z powrotem do roboty.
She's almost crying and she tries to control herself and gets her emotion down and turns around to continue.
Tutaj wiesz, zdarzyło się coś takiego.
Here happens something like this.
So, wiem, że czasem się zdarza.
I know that sometimes it happens.
Mianowicie jest coś zbyt oczywistego w tym.
There is something too evident in it.
To znaczy, ona podchodzi albo za daleko od kamery, albo za blisko do kamery.
Someone comes too far to the camera or goes too far away from the camera.
I nagle to, co gra, staje się tak oczywiste.
And all of a sudden what the actor plays becomes so evident,
że nie chcemy jakby być uczestnikami tej niedyskrecji, którą nam fundujesz.
That it's as if we do not want to participate in this creep thing the actor is proposing.
Tak jak to jest zrobione w tej chwili,
as
mamy uczucie, że uczestniczymy w tym czymś szalenie niedyskretnym.
We have the feeling as viewers that we are participating in something very indiscreet.
Jakbyśmy towarzyszyli aktorowi, który poszedł do klozetu, rozumiesz? Jest
as if we are going with the actor to the closet.
My oczywiście wiemy, że królowa angielska chodzi do klozetu, ale nie ma żadnego powodu, żeby za nią tam iść.
Of course we know that the Queen of England also goes to her PP in the closet, but we do not feel any need to go there with her.
A to jest coś takiego, że coś obserwujemy niedyskretnie.
And this is something like this. We all of a sudden observe something indiscreet.
Gdybyś użył innego światła w tym miejscu.
If you would have used another light in this, for this particular moment.
Gdyby ona się odwróciła od kamery.
If she would have turned away from the camera.
Albo gdyby podeszła tak blisko.
Or so close to the camera.
Żebyśmy zobaczyli tylko drżenie jej kącików ust.
That we only would see this trembling of her lips in this moment.
To być może byśmy byli gotowi to przyjąć.
We would be ready to accept this.
Ale jeżeli ona stoi w pełnym świetle,
but if she stands there in full light,
w takim planie,
in such a plan, shot,
jest coś niedyskretnego w tym.
That there is something indiscreet in it.
Ja mam uczucie osobiście, że ja bym chciał wyjść z tego pokoju, bo tu się dzieje coś takiego, co ja nie chcę patrzeć.
This moment I feel like that I need to go out of this room because I don't want to look at this.
To dotyczy właśnie tych dwóch miejsc.
This especially it's concerned these two moments, love.
To akurat jest bardzo łatwe do zmontowania, dlatego masz ujęcie na nią z tyłu.
And because you have a shot at her from the back, so this is easy to skip this one and to replace it.
Wiemy, o co tu jeszcze chodzi dodatkowo.
There is one thing more. I now
mianowicie, realize. My wiemy, co ona przeżywa od pierwszego momentu, kiedy ona odchodzi od stołu.
We know from the very beginning when she leaps from the table what she is wiemy. Going through.
Wiemy, a następnie ty każesz nam na to patrzeć.
And next you force us to look at this.
Chociaż my już wiemy.
Although we know already.
Już wiemy, co ona przeżywa.
We know.
I teraz tniesz z tego planu.
And from this shot you
tniesz
cut
na ten plan, kiedy ona się odwraca.
To the shot that she turns around.
Więc wystarczy, jeżeli przetniesz dużo wcześniej.
So if you would cut much earlier.
Z tego planu, w którym ona odchodzi od stołu, podchodzi do kamery.
From the moment that she goes to the camera.
Albo w tym momencie, kiedy ona zaczyna już.
When she starts.
Wiemy, o co tu jeszcze chodzi dodatkowo.
There is one thing more. I now
mianowicie,
realize.
My wiemy, co ona przeżywa od pierwszego momentu, kiedy ona odchodzi od stołu.
We know from the very beginning, when she leaps from the table, what she is wiemy. Going through.
Wiemy, a następnie ty każesz nam na to patrzeć.
And next you force us to look at this.
Chociaż my już wiemy.
Although we know already.
Już wiemy, co ona przeżywa.
We know.
I teraz tniesz z tego planu.
And from this shot you
tniesz
cut
na ten plan, kiedy ona się odwraca.
To the shot that she turns around.
Więc wystarczy, jeżeli przetniesz dużo wcześniej.
So if you would cut much earlier.
Z tego planu, w którym ona odchodzi od stołu, podchodzi do kamery.
From the moment that she goes to the camera.
Albert, w tym momencie, kiedy ona zaczyna już.
When she starts.
Tniesz.
You cut.
I patrzysz na nią z tyłu.
And then you look at her from the back.
I wiesz, co ona przeżywa, ale nie widzisz.
And we know what she is going through, but we don't see it.
I uważam, że to jest ciekawsze i to właśnie pozwoli nam
and I think it's more interesting.
Uniknąć tego momentu niedyskretnie.
And it will skip this moment, which I call indiscreet.
The second director is Francesco Ranieri Martinotti from Italy, who directed the same scene twice with a completely different cast.
You know, sometimes I think everything is so utterly pointless. I mean, why should we grudge ourselves all the good things in life? Why can't we be big and fat and good-tempered? Just think how nice that would make us. Do you remember Aunt Miriam and Uncle David? They were the perfect dears, and they were always together, and they were so fat. And they would lie there in that big old creaky double bed, holding hands. And they were so content with each other, just the way they were, just fat and cheerful. Couldn't you and I be just a little more like Aunt Miriam and Uncle David? And just being together and comfortable and safe. What is it, Johan? Are you worried about something? Has something happened? Tell me.
I came home to tell you something. I've fallen in love. quite absurd. And maybe it's all a damn mistake. Probably is a damn mistake. I met her during the convention in June. She was the interpreter and secretary. Actually, she's studying for her degree. She's going to teach Slavic languages. She's nothing much to look at. In fact, you would surely think she was ugly. I don't know where this will lead to. I don't know anything. I'm totally bewildered. Of course, I'm pleased in one way. Though I have a hell of a lot of bad conscience about you and the children. We've got along very well, haven't we? I mean, things haven't been any better or worse for us than the average family. Please say something.
I don't know what to say.
Co jest dla mnie bardzo zabawne.
What for me is really funny.
Wracając do tego, co powiedziałeś, że przyjeżdżamy z domu z jakimiś uczuciami.
Coming back to you, that people come here from their home, particular homes, with their own emotions.
To jest ciekawa różnica w stosunku do tej sceny pomiędzy Leifem i Franceską.
It's so funny thing to observe the different approach from Leif towards this scene and yours.
Zwłaszcza, że Leif pochodzi z kraju północnego.
Comes from a country in the north.
Słynie z tego, że ludzie nie pokazują.
Countries which are famous for people being not wanting to show their emotions.
Zakrywają wszystko.
They close them up.
Tymczasem on chce od aktorów jak najwięcej emocji.
And even from the actors as much as possible.
Even too much sometimes.
Even too much sometimes.
Ty pochodzisz z kraju, gdzie emocji jest za dużo na ulicy.
And you come from a country where there is too much emotions on the street.
Yeah. In the parliament.
As well,
anyway. I chcesz od aktorów ciszy i spokoju.
And you want from them silence and rest and
reakcji na
minuscule reactions.
Tak czy owak, nie udało nam się sfotografować w zbliżeniu tych łez, które Pamela miała w oczach w Mastershocie.
Yes, but it's a pity we didn't succeed in getting tears of Pamela, which were in the Mastershot present.
Yeah. It was not the tears really, but it's something that is shiny on the eyes.
Christoph told us 3 days ago, this is a scene of the woman.
Tak, ale widzisz, co się stało. Tak rzeczywiście mówiłem.
What is the result? It's what I have said before.
To jest prawda, tak mówiłem.
It's true.
Ale teraz, jak patrzę na to, co zmontowałeś,
but when I look at this, what you edited right now,
to teraz bym tak nie powiedział.
Then I would not have told this to you.
Nie, ponieważ to jest ta scena o nim.
Because it's also a scene about him.
Yes. I kiedy ci się, wydaje mi się, że ci się to właśnie udało zrobić w montażowni.
And I think you succeeded in getting this result in the editing room by making the scene about him as well.
Niekoniecznie w czasie zdjęć.
Not necessarily during shooting.
Natomiast udało ci się to w montażowni, dlatego bo znalazłeś
editing room you seem to have found a way.
Dwie dobre jego reakcje.
Two very good reactions from his side.
I jeżeli się nie mylę, to użyłeś reakcji z innych fragmentów jej tekstu.
And as far as I know, you use a reaction from him from a different spot than he was reacting during the scene.
Yeah? Yes. To jest skądinąd bardzo ciekawe dla Matiasa, jeżeli jest.
That's something very interesting for Matias. He's here the first.
Ja. To jest bardzo ciekawe dla ciebie, Matias, bo on it's używa swoich reakcji.
He uses a reaction from you which he needed.
Z innych momentów.
From a different moment akcji. During the scene.
I nagle okazuje się, że te reakcje funkcjonują właśnie w tych miejscach, a nie w tamtych, gdzie oryginalnie
były.
Na przykład reakcja takiego uśmiechu na te, tuż przed tym, czy pamiętasz wujka i ciocię. To jest reakcja z innego fragmentu, wydaje się.
There was a smile, I think, from another moment. Ja?
Yes, sure.
Ja. Ale to funkcjonuje bardzo dobrze.
But it was very well, this very appropriate.
I to nas właśnie, to jest właśnie powód, że dzisiaj bym się wycofał ze zdania, że to jest scena o kobiecie.
So, and this is why I now withdraw my thesis that it would be a scene just about a woman.
Nie, to jest też scena o mężczyźnie.
It's also a scene about a man.
Ponieważ ten uśmiech
because this smile, this jest, moment,
pokazuje, że Boże, dlaczego nie? Rzeczywiście mogłoby tak być.
Because he thinks also at this moment, I think that he might think, well, why, for God's sake, why couldn't it be this way?
Dlaczego nie mogłoby być tak spokojnie,
why
tak cicho?
I be so fat dlaczego? And silent and why not?
I ta reakcja, która jest ludzka bardzo,
and that's a very human reaction,
zbliża nas do bohatera, do mężczyzny.
Makes us come closer to him at this point.
I tak to jest.
That's the way it is.
You realize that the scene concerned Johan as well as Marianne.
Yeah.
But when you're a director is diagnosing a scene, can you always pinpoint it down to one person? And that's what you should do.
Nie, wcale nie trzeba tak zawsze robić.
No, it's not necessary to do this always.
Wcale tak nie trzeba robić. Raz jest tak, raz jest tak.
Once you do, once you don't.
Ciekawe jest tylko to, że możemy znaleźć emocje w montażowni, których wcale nie ma na zdjęciach.
What's interesting is we can find in the editing room emotions in the material which were not there
during the shooting. Yeah. This is this. Yes. And this is a good Annika, it's a good reason to go back to the editing room, you see? Or sometimes we can find something which you don't expect it to exist.
Yeah,
natomiast nie ma takiego powodu, żeby powiedzieć, żeby ciągle mówić sobie, że to jest scena o nim lub
it's
o niej albo
no
o obu razem. Oczywiście, że czasem trzeba to wyraźnie powiedzieć po to, żeby zwrócić uwagę wszystkich. Ale widzisz, tutaj na przykład ja zmieniłem trzy razy zdanie. Kiedy przyszedłem na zdjęcia, myślałem, że to jest scena o nich obojgu. Kiedy po zdjęciach myślałem, że to jest scena o kobiecie. A teraz uważam, że to jest scena o nich obojgu.
As a rule, surely, when you approach shooting, it's best to have it clear in your mind who you want the audience sympathies with.
Absolutely, yeah.
And that you should try and focus that down to one person.
Co?
Czy masz tę sympatię właśnie określić do jednej osoby?
Niekoniecznie. Dlaczego? Możesz lubić wszystkich. Możesz lubić wszystkich, każdy jest, choć wszyscy są po przeciwnych stronach barykady. Dlatego mówię, że nie ma reguły.
There are no rules.
Natomiast reguła jest taka, że trzeba określić, kogo będzie się lubić, tak?
You have to be aware of the fact whom would you like people to give their sympathy.
Okay, Matthias. Don't think about the other scene. You are here, very intimate. It's a very intimate place. No, you have to feel that you are married. No, no. Don't, because if we think to other things, we can get to the real. But you have to see that you are married.
It's just that I just have to.
to. I just have to make the arrangements. It's terrible.
No, and then yesterday we had a rehearsal and we just went through the logic of the text and we tried to find the life of it and. First, we did it without all the objects. We were just trying to see what it means to us, also certain things, and then we included all the objects, like the bread and the logic of the scene, which changed some things. And we did it very much in detail, like which way to go. And we always would stop when there's one question, like, well, why do you take now the knife in? And it was not logical because there was no reason to take the knife, and we would try to clear all these little things. And I can just say, for me, what I appreciated most in this work was that I felt that things were really taken care of, and that I was really being perceived as a person and regarded. Yeah, and then Francesco looked what maybe he can do with me, and that for me felt very good.
Yes, about the goal of the scene that you always ask, no? The what I want to reach. John, the problem is this sense of guilty that he has, no? And also this very big difficult to find the moment to say that to throw. I told them to throw the bomb, and he tried to find this moment to throw the bomb, and he thought to throw the bomb and to escape, you know, because it's only way to go until the end of his idea, and Pamela is completely stone, and he's like a child that it's. It doesn't. She doesn't understand, no. With his eyes open, that are looking to find something, to catch something, to stand, no. To don't fall down. And yes, something that we thought. You remember that the last line that. Joan said in the end, say something for Christ's sake, no? I thought that it could be better if it's like a prayer that he does. Please say something. It's not violent. It's not.
Yeah.
Because he need to be understood, no? And so he will be more soft than before, no?
I came home to tell you something. I've fallen in love. It's quite absurd, and maybe it's all a damn mistake. Probably is a damn mistake. I met her during the convention in June. She was the interpreter and secretary. Actually, she's studying for a degree.
You have to give us the image of Paola. First you have to imagine her and describe her. She's the secretary, the interpreter. And don't worry about the lines, because you are too much worried about the lines. Think about Paola or some. Imagine, who can be Paola for you? Some girl that you like a lot, but think to her. This is important because you don't change this gear. It's always the same level of. And then I think that you have to see Paola in your glass.
in this, you start looking at her, but then Paula is here, and so you see her in the glass.
I don't know how to do it. You know, you want to say like that, or you want to say like that. Do some, but do a little minimal things on your face. Show her that something happened. So in this case, now you know that something happened. So it's quite normal. So tell me, simply tell me. There are no secrets. There are no secrets between us. Tell no secrets. So tell me. In this case, it will be more difficult for you to start, but it will be better for the scene. Hmm?
This grow of your fear that something happened, you have to think first that he doesn't like Aunt Mary and Uncle David. Then you have to think that he has some problem with his job. Then you have to think that probably his mother he has a big disease, he has a cancer, no? And then you realize that it's something that concerns both of you. And if you have this thought, you can have a step of your thought, and you can change the acting in the direction to be more strong and more fear.
Yeah, that is the same. Yes, to show the way.
Yes,
to show the way.
The suggestion.
Which way you will say these sentences about her? That she's not very nice, she's not very pretty, and you even can think that she's ugly. But for you, she's not ugly at all. She's beautiful, and she smells nice, and she makes you so so excited about the sex, about the future, that we have to feel it now. Even if you say something completely different, you know, this is the difference between what you are thinking and what you are seeing now, mm-hmm. and what you are talking about. How you are talking about it. It's a completely contradiction, but you have to keep her picture pod powiekami.
Under your eyelids.
Yeah.
Under your eyelids.
You see her. Yeah?
Has something happened? Tell me.
I came here this evening to tell you something. I've fallen in love. It's quite absurd. Maybe it's all a damn mistake. Probably is a damn mistake. I met her during the convention in June. She was the interpreter and secretary. Actually, she's studying for a degree. She's going to teach Slavic language. She's nothing much to look at. In fact, you undoubtedly would think she was ugly. I don't know where this will lead to. I don't know anything. I'm totally bewildered. Of course, I'm pleased in one way. Though I have a hell of a bad conscience about you and the children. We've got along very well, haven't we? I mean, things haven't been any better or worse for us than the average family.
I came here this evening to tell you something. I've fallen in love. It's quite absurd. Probably it's all a damn mistake. I met her during the film shooting in March. She was a wardrobe assistant. But actually, she's studying production design at the academy. You know her. Girl with the blonde hair, a little bit skinny. You met her in the blinker, you remember, when I forgot your birthday. I like her, and I want to live with her. It kills me to think of what I'm doing to you and the children. I know, we are great together. We've come so far and achieved so much. And a lot of people want to be like us. But say something, for Christ's sake.
I don't know what to say.
Stop. Don't be hurried to say the last line.
Oh, it can be come from much deeper, yes. Don't mind if you take it a little bit.
Okay. And the problem is always, what is it? No? What is it? You have to give more energy to her, because you...
Yeah?
Yes.
If you have something more disturbing.
Yeah.
All right. Yes, no, I just...
Go inside, yeah?
Yeah, I go inside.
Yes, but you
maybe
have to...
It's too small.
You have to give the same energy, because you need your energy.
All right. Good. You met her at the blinker. Remember? When I forgot your birthday. I like her. And I want to live with her. It kills me to think of what I'm doing to you and the children. I know. We are great together and we've come so far and achieved so much. A lot of people would like to be like us. But say something, for Christ's sake.
don't know what to say.
Oh, it's not bad, huh? Yeah, no.
I'm very sorry.
No.
I keep forgetting things.
Yes, but we can do another, but it's only for you, because it was okay. I like a lot your sense of losing, no?
Yeah,
that you are lost. Yeah. You feel like, and in that certain point, we see that you hate him.
Yeah.
This is.
Yeah, that's.
Yes.
I spotkaliśmy się z dwoma zupełnie różnymi kobietami, z dwoma różnymi aktorkami.
We have met two different kind of women and two different kind of actresses.
Myślę, że twoje nadzieje związane z tym, że się dostaniemy do prywatnego życia pomiędzy Delicke i Reinhardem nie sprawdziły się.
I think that your idea about getting close into what was real between Nelleke and Reinhardt in their real life, that that it was not fulfilled.
Nic z tego właśnie nie wynikało.
Nothing extra probably came out from out of this point of view.
To oznacza dla mnie przynajmniej, że
which means for me at least,
że prawda o aktorze jest ukryta gdzieś głębiej.
That the truth about the actor is hidden somewhere more deeply.
Że tego się nie da zauważyć i sfotografować przy takiej zewnętrznym założeniu, że oto mamy prawdziwą parę, która zagra prawdziwą parę, która jest jednocześnie inną parą.
That we will not discover this by taking just a couple of actors who are a couple in real life as well, and this external truth doesn't show something extra.
Krótko scharakteryzuję tą różnicę.
If I can summarize this difference very briefly.
Na przykładzie wczorajszej sceny, oczywiście.
At the example of the scene of yesterday, of course.
Przy końcu, kiedy Pamela powiedziała, nie wiem co powiedzieć.
Well, at the end Pamela said, I don't know what to say.
Naprawdę nie wiedziała co powiedzieć.
She really didn't know what to say.
Ponieważ przypuszczam, że w życiu prywatnym byłoby też jej szalenie trudno powiedzieć w tym momencie cokolwiek.
Because I suppose that for her in real life, in a similar situation, it would be similar, that she would not really know what to say.
Ona była bardzo bliska płaczu.
She was really very close to crying.
I mieliśmy poczucie, że ona wszystko straciła.
And we had a feeling that she lost everything.
I że ona nie będzie o to walczyć.
And she will not fight for this.
Odwrotnie przy Nelleke.
Opposite with Nelleke.
Nelleke powiedziała, nie wiem co powiedzieć.
At the end Nelleke said, I don't know what to say.
Dlatego, bo nie chciała powiedzieć.
Because she didn't want to say.
Nienawidzę cię.
I hate you.
Jesteś gnojem.
You are fucking shit.
I pogardzam tobą.
And I despise you.
Po prostu tak mi się wydaje, że toczyły się uczucia Nelleke w tej scenie.
That's probably how her feelings were at the end of the scene.
W jej spojrzeniu była nienawiść i pogarda.
In her face was despisement hate.
W spojrzeniu Pabeli była bezradność.
In the face of Pamela was helplessness.
I słabość.
And weakness.
Pamela byłaby, gdybyśmy zastanawiali się nad castingiem.
So if this would have been a casting session?
Pamela byłaby aktorką, która by zagrała tą rolę z dużą kobiecą słabością.
She would play the role which is to be played with a lot of female weakness.
Nelleke odwrotnie, zagrałaby ją z ogromną kobiecą siłą.
And Nelleke would play this with an enormous female strength.
Z tej wartości, wydaje mi się, tej różnicy i tych obu wartości, bo obie te rzeczy są wartościowe.
And both elements are very valuable.
Nie wykorzystałeś do końca.
But you could have just explored them more and analyzed them more and used it.
To jest drobny incydent pomiędzy Pamelą a mną.
It's a small incident which happened between Pamela and me.
To jest wtedy, kiedy ci powiedziałem, że troszkę zbyt kokieteryjnie to grać.
It was when I told her that she was playing a little bit too coquette.
Wiesz, ja bym ci nigdy tego nie powiedział w trakcie prawdziwych zdjęć.
I would have never told you this during a real shooting.
Publicznie.
In public.
Zawsze bym cię wziął na bok.
I would always have taken you aside.
I powiedziałbym to tylko do ciebie, żebyś tylko ty o tym wiedział.
It, this is only for you that you should know.
Nie, czasem trzeba powiedzieć coś przykrego.
Sometimes it's necessary to say something painful.
I trzeba to zrobić.
And then if it's necessary, you have to do so.
I każdy musi to zrobić.
Everyone has.
Także reżyser musi mieć odwagę powiedzenia czegoś przykrego.
Even the director needs the courage to say something painful if it's necessary.
I teraz wracam do problemu zaufania.
Now I come back to the problem of trust.
Uważam, że tylko wtedy można mieć zaufanie do siebie wzajemne, jeśli mówi się sobie prawdę.
And I think that we can only trust each other when we know that we tell the truth.
Oczywiście nie do końca.
Not the whole truth.
Ale przynajmniej część prawdy.
But at least part of the truth.
I teraz, jeżeli przeprowadzisz króciuteńką analizę tego incydentu.
And if we now just analyze this incident very briefly.
Jeżeli ja powiem Pameli na boku.
If I say Pamela aside.
Pamela, jesteś zbyt kokieteryjna.
You are in this scene, you are a little bit too coquette.
To jest przykre dla niej oczywiście.
Of course that's painful to her.
Ale teraz, jeżeli kiedyś powiem Pamela.
But when I say to her next time,
to było fantastyczne.
Pamela, this was fantastic.
To ona wie, że to naprawdę było fantastyczne.
Then she will believe me that this really was fantastic.
Ponieważ wie, że potrafię ją też krytykować.
Because she knows that I am also capable of criticizing her when it comes to that.
I także z takich spięć buduje się zaufanie.
As a result
może się budować
of this, this tension, these two things to happen, that's the base for trust. This is where you build your trust on.
Powiedziałem to głośno tylko po to, żeby właśnie można było o tym potem porozmawiać.
I told it loudly only well to be able to talk about this later on.
Za co cię przepraszam.
And so now my excuse for saying this aloud at that moment.
I would like to say something. Because it's from what you said before, it seems that there were two very different points of where the two actresses arrived. And for me in rehearsal with Francesco, he asked me to arrive exactly at this point, that there's nothing anymore in this helplessness and about this journey. And so I played it because it had also to do with his interpretation. And now I feel like a little bit reduced as an actress, as if I could only do one thing, or if I...
No, not at all. Why?
Because you said that that it depends on the personality and who someone is. Yes, of course. And that
Pamela, it's very difficult for you to play a Rambo, isn't it?
You think it's easier for Nelly to play Rambo?
No, I don't think so. No, it's very difficult for you.
Yes, but we're not talking about Rambo and Marianne. I mean, like...
it's a little bit like that.
No, I think I could also play Rambo.
I don't think so.
I think so. I think so.
Okay. I will call Hatzenegger for this scene of Joanne Marianne.
I nie wiem, czy coś z tego wynika.
I don't know if there will result. This will result some, into something.
To już zależy od każdego z was osobno.
It, that is different for each of you.
Separately.
Yeah.
Dla mnie to jest ważne.
What's important for me?
To jest tak, że widzę, że to jest możliwe ciągle, że to jest ciągle możliwe, że jacyś obcy sobie ludzie spotykają się.
But it's still possible that people are strangers to each other in the beginning.
Spotykają się, zaczynają pracować ze sobą, zaczynają się lubić, mają ochotę sobie pomóc.
They start to work with each other, they start to like each other, they want to help each other.
Że jakby są otwarci na możliwość zobaczenia innego punktu widzenia, to jest też bardzo ważne.
Which is very important, that they are open and willing to see things from a different angle.
I że dostrzegają te inne punkty widzenia, że biorą je pod uwagę, zaczynają je brać pod uwagę.
They start to take into account the opportunities and the possibilities of seeing things from a different perspective.
Nie wiem, jak tak na was patrzę, to myślę, że może niektóre kontakty zostaną, że może będzie się do siebie pisać albo spotykać się czasami.
If I look around, I can observe that probably some of you will keep in contact with each other, maybe do some things together.
Może w jakiś sposób możecie sobie kiedyś pomóc.
Maybe you can help each other in future in a way.
Niezależnie od tego, co to będzie, czy to będzie pomoc życiowa, czy pomoc scenariuszowa, czy pomoc w zdjęciach.
It's not important whether this is a help in life or a help for screenplay or for shooting.
Ale myślę, że coś takiego jest możliwe, że coś takiego się urodziło tutaj.
But I think something of this, well, was born here.
I to był proces, który można było bardzo łatwo zaobserwować.
And that's a process which was easy to observe.
Który jakby się ewidentnie pogłębiał.
And it was evident that this process was one which was deepening, going more profound.
Więc wszystkim wam bardzo dziękuję.
So that's why I want to thank everyone. Of us.
Było dla mnie bardzo ciekawe was wszystkich spotkać.
It was quite interesting for me to meet every one of you.
It was interesting.
Interesting?
Not quite. Interesting.
Interesting.
Tak. To było ciekawe i myślę, że my się tak przez te dwa tygodnie nie znudzili za bardzo.
And I think we did not bore each other too much during these 2 weeks.
Co już można więcej chcieć?
So what can we ask more? What should we demand more?
Troszkę się polubić, nie zanudzić.
Just to like each other a little bit and not to bore each other.
This is the best word we can have in the life. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.